We were the lost ones. The Savior had already ascended back through the clouds about 27 minutes ago, according to my watch. I heard people who thought that they didn't deserve this fate, wailing and watering the dust in this empty car park, trying to tell God that they had been exceptional. I looked up. Bang on half past, God was back carrying an old Volvo, and he said to us, "I'm bringing a few more of these so you guys can drive to heaven. The Guinness punch and the jerk chicken will probably be gone by the time you guys get there, but I'll leave the waltzes and the Ferris wheel. Good luck, because the fire and brimstone will be coming down soon." He disappeared back into the sky. I never thought God could look so small. I guess that's why he usually ascends through low clouds. It was unorganized. People were sprinting, and I didn't even realize I was tearing through this last pizza slice-like situation as well. I clambered into the car, but people wouldn't stop, though the car was now impregnated with 18 ecstatic souls. There were 3 in the front, including the driver, 10 in the back. People settled between feet in fetal positions, faces squashed against windows, 4 in the boot, and 1 person, angel garment knuckle gripping onto the bonnet. The driver looked at us all, giggling as she raced off. The idea of heaven had never been appealing to me, and Sabbath had always been the bane of my week, but now, God was saying there was going to be Guinness punch? I hadn't even been paying attention to the road, but when I looked up, the trees were bending their branches, making a flat road ahead of us, the ones in front springing higher straight out of the concrete. It was only interesting for a couple of seconds. Then I decided that sleeping would feel like clean bedding right now. Looked at the people around me. Realized that the person to my right was so attractive that I forgot how to speak, and when I remembered, my words came out like Bambi on ice. I said something about whether they minded if I leaned on them while I slept, because I'm really self-conscious about touching people unless it's really necessary, and it seldom is. It was fine. It usually is. I dreamt that the sky was made of jigsaw pieces that would float down on command and take you anywhere you wanted to go. I jumped up, asked the driver how she knew where she was going. She said, "We'll be in the forecourt in a minute." She hadn't answered my question. I started counting to 60. By the time I got to 45, just like in my dream, a piece of sky just big enough for the car dropped, landed directly in front of us. The driver instantly put the handbrake on, and we shot into the sky. I lost count, but it felt like less than 15 seconds before I heard music and was hurtled back to my childhood, their temptations as thick as porridge in the air. Everything was dark, but the road was shimmering like moonlit water. I looked at the people around me, realized that the women were in batty riders, and the men were in string vests and gold chains. Everyone was looking around so confused until the driver broke the silence by saying, "Jesus Christ, I have good skin." And we all looked around and realized that we all now had amazing skin. The driver chuckled and drove into the gates. Exactly as God said, the waltzes and the Ferris wheel were still up, and the 18 of us danced. Dancing wouldn't exist after us.